This video will show you how to perform a two-way ANOVA test using Excel. Here are the hardness data obtained from bread stored in different packaging for different storage periods. There are two factors affecting bread hardness. One is packaging type and the other is storage length. To conduct the two-way ANOVA, first go to the Data tab located on the top panel in Excel. Then click on Data Analysis. From the list of statistical tests, select ANOVA two-factor with replication. Now a window will appear allowing you to enter data for analysis. To input data, click on the square icon by the input range box. Proceed to drag your cursor over your entire data set, including the headings. Enter the number of replicates you have for each sample in the row per sample box. For this set of data, there are 5 replicates for each sample. Set the alpha level to 0.05 and select output range or a new worksheet for your ANOVA table. Then click OK. An ANOVA table will show up. In the summary table, the average and variance of each group are included. To determine if there are statistically significant differences between groups, look at the ANOVA table at the bottom. Here, sample is referring to the types of packaging, and columns is referring to length of storage period. First, look at the p-value for sample. If the p-value is smaller than alpha, you can reject the null hypothesis and there are statistically significant differences among the hardness of bread stored in different types of packaging. F-value can be compared to f-critical value as well. When f-value is greater than f-critical, you can reject the null hypothesis. In this case, both storage time and packaging were significant. However, there was no interaction because the p-value for interaction was greater than 0.05. To confirm which of the samples are significantly different, we can use an LSD test.